What if I told you that you can mine bitcoins inside your regular MySQL database that powers web applications all around the world? Now, I'm just a JavaScript developer, so how on earth am I supposed to mine bitcoins with MySQL? Well, let me introduce you to Oracle's latest game changer, JavaScript in MySQL. That's right, the newest version of MySQL lets you execute JavaScript code right inside the database. Also, I will make sure to say both MySQL and MySQL in this video just to make sure that I piss off every single one of you. Comment the correct pronunciation down below. To execute JavaScript inside of MySQL, we use something called stored programs. Stored programs can be saved into the MySQL database with a special syntax using create function. Below that, we have the source code of the function written in JavaScript. We can also pass arguments and return the result of the function. After all of that is set up, we can use select to execute the function and get back the result. At least, that's what it says in the announcement, where it also promises best end-to-end performance. Whatever that means, I'm sure it's a great sign for our Bitcoin miner. The easiest way to set up MySQL JavaScript is Oracle's MySQL Heatwave service, where everything is configured out of the box. But I won't burn money on such a silly little side project, I mean the future barebone of my financial existence, so we will go down the hard route. While the new JavaScript feature is available in MySQL Enterprise Edition, which can be downloaded for free, it requires manual installation and configuration. Creating a function does not initially work and returns an error. Luckily, there's a short and concise 6,400 pages PDF that provides all the information that you could possibly need to set up a MySQL Enterprise server. And believe it or not, somewhere in there I actually found the information that we need to make it run. In the end, it was just a single command to install the multilingual engine component and enable support for JavaScript. You really couldn't put that in the announcement post, Oracle? What they did claim in the announcement post, however, is that you can reuse millions of available third-party packages from online packet managers such as npm. But in reality, there's no support for file access or any third-party modules inside of MySQL JavaScript, which is clearly stated in the compact 6,400 pages PDF. So what I ended up doing is bundling all those dependencies using rollup. Now that we can execute JavaScript, how do we actually mine a Bitcoin block? Thankfully, there are a few open source implementations out there which I liberated, changed and redistributed. To mine a block in Bitcoin, you have to find some magic number that can be easily verified by anyone but is hard to find originally. You know you have the correct magic number if you take some predefined data, hash it and look if the hash meets a certain requirement. Hashing is the process of transforming data into a fixed length value that looks something like this. And the criteria that the hash has to meet is that it has to be lower than a certain threshold. The threshold is defined by the current difficulty level of Bitcoin, which rises constantly. To find a hash that meets our difficulty requirement, we add a number to the input for the hash and keep increasing it until we find a number that meets the requirement. If it meets the requirement, it is our magic number and we successfully mined the block. This might sound easy, but it can actually take a really long time to find a fitting magic number for a given Bitcoin block. As mining in Bitcoin is used as a method of verifying transactions and keep the network going, there is a reward for finding this magic number. If I were to mine and verify the current block by myself, I would get 6.25 bitcoins, which converts to about $250,000. But it might be a lot less when you are watching this, given the immense stability of Bitcoin. Because only one miner gets the reward for an entire block, reasonable miners distribute the risk by joining pools to mine together and distribute the rewards. But we are JavaScript developers, we are not reasonable. So let's put in all the data that is needed to mine one block inside the Bitcoin network. And sure enough, after only a few moments, we get a magic number that meets our requirements. But wait, does this mean that we are rich now? Not quite. The block that I just mined is very old, had very low difficulty level, and was mined initially a long time ago. While this proves that our implementation works, it is important to understand that it would take an unreasonable amount of time to mine blocks that are currently looking to be verified. But remember me when 10 years from now, all shady WordPress hosts finally update their databases to the newest version of MySQL, and an exploit allows some hackers to set up Bitcoin miners all across the internet to get filthy rich. My Bitcoin donation wallet address is of course in the description down below, where you can also find the link to the GitHub repository with all the code that is needed to play around with MySQL JavaScript by yourself. See you in the next video.